Welcome back to the Azure Enablement Show and our series on learning resources. I'm April Edwards, your host for the series. Now we'll continue our tour of resources ready to help you become a better Azure professional. So without further ado, let's head off to our first destination.
Our next stop is at Video Series.
My name is Isaac Levin, Senior Product Marketing Manager in Azure Marketing at Microsoft.
When developers go to the Video Series, what do they find there?
So one of a great learning destination for folks getting started in tech is all the sort of video channels that we have on top of YouTube and Channel 9. So there's all sorts of videos that we could take a look at, whether it be Microsoft Azure, Azure Developer, or Visual Studio. Those allow us to get all sorts of granularity as it pertains to video content for different levels of skill.
Why should developers go to the Video Series?
Developers are always looking to learn and play with the newest technologies. And the videos that Microsoft provides give you just that, the ability to watch all sorts of great content in the developer space, not just content that could be valuable for you right now, but for you in the future.
Is there anything in the Video Series that will help developers feel right at home?
One of the big things that's really, really valuable about some of the video content that we have is that it's suitable to all levels. So for instance, if you're just getting started in tech as a developer or you're very seasoned, we have all sorts of different content that allow you to fully feel at home.
Are there any content sections in the Video Series that developers might want to pay attention to?
One thing that's really, really valuable about a video series such as Learn.net, for instance, developers that are in the .NET space are always looking to learn new things. And we have these short 2 to 5 minute video segments and the course of series that allow you to be able to learn from your favorite developers and learn about content that might be valuable for not just you right now, but you in the future.
What is one thing that most developers might not know about the Microsoft Video Series?
I think one of the things that people don't see about our videos is that they're produced very, very well. So in the situation where you have lots and lots and lots of content, sometimes content gets drowned out just because of the vast amount of content. So one of the things that we like to do at Microsoft is make sure that our content is not only engaging, but fun as well.
Coming up, we go to Microsoft OpenHack.
Hi, I'm Tristan Gorange, and I'm a program manager within commercial software engineering, looking after the OpenHack program for Microsoft.
When someone goes to OpenHack for the first time, what do they find there and how do they get started?
Microsoft OpenHack is a hands-on, challenge-based, deeply technical upskilling experience where development teams progress through increasingly difficult challenges based on real-world customer scenarios designed to mimic the development journey. When teams join an OpenHack, they're typically comprised of 5 participants and 1 coach where they are formed at the very beginning of each OpenHack. Each team will act as its own dev crew, if you will, each one complementing each other's skill sets and experience so that they can complete each challenge based on the success criteria defined, all with the coach guiding them along the way. Teams are assigned a shared login to access the OpenHack classroom where gated challenges are presented, both with success criteria and additional resources for them to complete each challenge. Each participant will receive their own unique login to access a pre-provisioned set of resources, whether that be in Azure or other related services, so that they can then go complete each one of those challenges or tasks at hand. Teams who successfully complete an OpenHack will ultimately be able to demonstrate their new learnings with all their skills and workloads in their daily environments.
Why should developers get involved with OpenHacks?
Developers and adjacent technical roles should really consider participating in an OpenHack given it is the premium upskilling experience where you apply existing skills to solve real-world challenges found in your everyday industry scenarios.
How should a developer get started with OpenHacks?
To get started with an OpenHack, you'll first want to visit openhack.microsoft.com or contact your Microsoft account rep. One thing that will make you feel right at home when participating in an OpenHack is by making it a team experience. Invite your peers to upskill alongside you so you go through the OpenHack as a team and then bring that experience back to your organization.
How can you get the most from OpenHacks?
When participating in an OpenHack, it's important to come prepared. In advance, we provide you with suggested learning courses and toolings to come prepared with. Participants who do the pre-work really do have an edge and will accelerate through the OpenHack experience compared to others who don't necessarily read in advance.
What is one thing most developers may not know about open hacks?
One thing most developers may not know about open hack is that it is a feedback-driven experience. All the content, tools, and resources used during an open hack, participants actually have and are encouraged to provide actionable feedback through the open hack environment. We like to say feedback is a gift. Through a direct feedback loop with engineering, we take all that feedback and give it to them so they can help improve the product offerings and technical documentation that you ultimately end up using.
Our next stop takes us to Microsoft Reactors.
Hi, I'm Emily Hove, and I have the pleasure of running the program management team for the Global Reactor program for Microsoft.
When someone goes to Reactors for the first time, what do they find there and how do they get started?
Well, the best way to get started with Reactor is to join our community. We are found on meetup sites all over the world. And once you join our community, you have access to a wide range of events that are developed by developers, and they are curated by developers and IT pros for developers and IT pros. So there's a mix of content, whether you're just a beginner or you're more intermediate or advanced in your career. There's a wide variety of content delivered by Microsoft professionals, by our partners, and by third-party communities.
Why should developers get involved with Reactors?
Developers should go to the Reactors because Reactors were built for developers, and we provide content that is also developed by developers. So we understand how developers learn, how they want to learn, and we provide a wide variety of content for folks, whether they are wanting to learn about a new technology or whether they're interested in seeing expert panels discuss new and emerging technologies.
How should a developer get started with Reactors?
It's very easy for developers to get started with Reactors. Just go to our meetup site or go to our website and join one of our events, and that'll get you started. Also, if you're a developer and you have content that you're really wanting to try out and get out there to the world, Reactors is a great place to deliver content for developers.
How can developers get the most out of Reactors?
I think that developers can get the most out of Reactors by experimenting with going to different events. We have events that are based all around the globe. So if you're interested in hearing different perspectives, like maybe you want to hear about what's happening with security in Israel, join one of our events that is based out of Tel Aviv. So I would just say dive in, see what interests you most. And it's a great launch pad into seeing all that the Reactors have to offer. It's also a great segue and gateway into, you know, what Microsoft Learn is all about. Our content largely is live. We also have recorded content, but we direct you into a place where you can continue your learning path to Microsoft Learn and expanding your career.
What is one thing most developers might not know about Reactors?
What developers don't know about Reactors is that Reactors were founded with the developers in mind. And all of our content, all of our panel discussions, all of our workshops are actually built and delivered by developers for developers.
This stop of the tour, we go to Flagship Events.
Hi there, my name is Ed Donahue, and I am a senior content experience manager, which means that all of the content that you see at some of our events, I help that come to life.
When someone goes to the Flagship Events, what do they find and how do they get started?
When someone comes to one of our major events and one of our online events, which used to be our largest in-person events, so things like Microsoft Ignite or Microsoft Build, the very first thing you should do as an attendee is register. This will get you access to some of our really cool attendee tools that you can use throughout the event, and will also allow you to start building your schedule so that you make sure that you don't miss any sessions that you're interested in.
Why should developers go to the Flagship Events?
Developers should come to our Flagship Events to be inspired and to learn about the latest news around Microsoft development products.
How do developers get started with the Flagship Events?
As a developer, the very first thing you should do is, of course, register for the event. Once you register, you'll have access to some of our digital swag. just because we're doing a digital event doesn't mean there isn't swag. So you'll have access to likely some backgrounds or badges or even some bingo cards that you can play along at home while you watch some of our keynote or featured sessions. Once you're in the event, some great places to go to connect with other people who might be running into the same technical issues as you or try and figure out some bugs that you may have is to head to some of our sessions in the connection zone where you can connect with other attendees, find some community sessions, or also talk to Microsoft experts about specific problems that you're having.
Are there any parts of the flagship events that developers should pay particular attention to?
I think some of our best sessions for developers will be within the connection zone. In the connection zone, you can talk with other attendees through our attendee networking. You can also talk with Microsoft experts in our Ask the Expert sessions and talk with other community members in our table talk sessions. Some great sessions that actually offer an instructor-led lab type experience are Learn Live sessions. And you can find these at Microsoft Ignite. And it's an instructor-led full lab that you can walk through during your time at the event.
What is one thing most developers might not know about the flagship events?
If you are just getting into development, or if you are wanting to get into development, a really great resource for you will be our Intro to Tech Skills sessions. And those will be really awesome sessions. They might be around specific development platforms. It might be around mixed reality. It might even be around changing careers. But those are super great resources if you are new to development and if you're looking to get started.
I hope you've enjoyed our tour across Azure Learning Resources. If you're looking to engage with any of the resources we visited in this video, please check the text in this video's description. Enjoy your learning and see you next time.